Welcome to Comprehensive Current Affairs presented by Narayana IAS Academy. This is About Me. Today we will be discussing about the world record achieved by Kaiga Nuclear Power Plant, the slogan given by Prime Minister in Indian Science Congress, Parivesh App, Bhumi Rashi Portal, India's role in development of Afghanistan, Chang'e Lunar Probe, non-convertible ventures and inclusion of tribes. The start time for each topic is given in the description. Kaiga Nuclear Power Plant, which is located in the northwest coast of Karnataka by the river Kali, has attained a new world record. It has worked uninterrupted for 962 days, okay, without any shutdown or maintenance. It has worked continuously. This is very important for India because, firstly, right from the stage of conception, planning, construction, working and maintenance, this is done by our own Nuclear Power Corporation of India, and many of the important equipment is manufactured by public sector unit BHEL. Therefore, this puts lot of trust, reliability on our indigenous technology. In previously, we saw protest in Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal against the construction of nuclear power plant. This shows that there is no need to worry. People need not worry about the nuclear power plants that are constructed by us because they are very reliable, they are proven. Okay. Second news. Prime Minister of India in Indian Science Congress going on in Punjab gave the slogan Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, Jai Vignan and Jai Anusandhan. The meaning of this is that the scientists and other technocrats across India should innovate technology for the use of local problems. That is Jai Vigyan, that is innovation should be done to meet the local needs and this should be integrated into the society. This quote is very simple and it has to be used in essay and any question related to science and technology in GS paper 3. Parivesh. Parivesh is proactive and responsive facilitation by interactive, virtuous and environmental single window hub. This is a big name, Parivesh, just simply Parivesh. This portal is launched by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Okay. This provides a single window system to get clearances for environment, forest, wildlife and coastal regulatory zone. Okay. This is another name for this is Integrated Environmental Management System. Okay. This is developed by NIC, National Informatics Center. Okay. Right from the stage of filing a request, monitoring and management of the proposal, paying the fees or etc. will be done on this portal. Thereby, ease of doing business in India will improve. Moving on, Bhumi Rashi Portal. Bhumi Rashi Portal was inaugurated by Ministry of Road Transportation and Highways. This is important. We will look at Bhumi Rashi and maybe think this is might be related to agriculture or environment or land revenue or something. No, it is Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. Okay, the aim of this portal is to make the process of acquisition of land for the purpose of construction of national highways, payment of compensation to the landowners, okay, all these things previously they used to be done manually or physical movement of the documents need to be done. This is very slow process causing delays, and because of this portal the whole thing is designed to be made faster and the whole thing is going to be automated. Okay. Therefore, people need not go to the offices day in, day out for their compensation, nor lot of documents are required. Okay. This is very important for ease of doing business and faster construction of highways and to reduce the NPAs in infrastructure. This is third is very important point. We see lot of NPAs, right? So even if NPA answer is asked in the mains exam, you can write the name on this portal. Okay. Moving on. Recently, President Donald Trump of USA has ridiculed India. He said that while we are fighting wars and investing a lot of things, Indians are only constructing libraries. library and other things which are not very useful. Okay, but this is rejected by India, and they call this is not as true. Firstly, India says that, okay, we do not send our armed forces abroad. Okay, we do not for any purpose, we do not send our armed forces abroad except under the specific mandate of UN peacekeeping operations. Okay, if Indian forces are to go to United States, okay, United States Security Council. Security Council is the one who sends peacekeeping operations. Only then Indian forces will go there. Secondly, it is not true that we are not contributing. We have contributed for economic and human development of Afghanistan. Let us go through them. Firstly, Indian corporate and government has invested almost $10.8 billion in Afghanistan by 2012 only. We have constructed a steel plant, a 6 million tons per annum steel plant, an 800 megawatt power plant, hydroelectricity power projects, transmission lines and roads. Okay. And second important aspect is we have completed the reconstruction of Salma Dam. Salma Dam is on the river Hari in the Herat province. Okay, this not only produces 42 megawatts of power, but also irrigates 75,000 hectares of farmland in Chisti Sarif district. Thirdly, we have invested more than 100 million on Chabahar port, and we have constructed a Zaranj Delaram highway, okay, which connects Iran to Afghanistan. Now, what is happening? Okay, there is another important point. Many prominent Indian companies such as Gammon India, SpiceJet, Phoenix and Aptek, they have invested in Afghanistan on economic projects. We have also inaugurated dedicated air cargo corridor. We know that Pakistan is playing spoilsport. Pakistan does not want India and Afghanistan trade to improve. But we have launched a dedicated air cargo corridor so that products, okay, mainly primary agricultural products, which if they come by road or ship, they spoil. Na? So we launched an air cargo corridor. What is happening because of all these things? The employment has been created in Afghanistan. Economic development is happening. And we know that mostly it is unemployed youth, okay, who gets attracted to terrorism. Because of all this economic activity that is created by Indians, right? Many people, they want to work, they want to do honest work rather than go to violent activities. Okay, so this is very important contribution made by India. Secondly, we are also constructing an important agricultural university. Okay, we are also constructing public and private schools. We are sponsoring 1,000 scholarships, and right now there are 16,000 Afghan students in India. Indian education is not as costly as that in Western world. Therefore, many Afghanistan students are more encouraged to come to India. Okay, we are also, because of this education, they're more capacity building, training is given. So they can go back to their country, they can work in many spheres. Okay, therefore, this is very important. Along with it, We are also giving training and capacity building to the civil servants and police forces. Okay, therefore, all these things they're providing the economic backbone for development of Afghanistan. Along with this, we are also cooperating on security. We have exported some helicopters, some other military equipment for the Afghanistan military. We also train Afghanistan military. So there is all-round contribution of India to Afghanistan. This is not short-term. We are contributing since last 10-15 years. So the statement given by US President Donald Trump on Indian contribution to Afghanistan is utter false. Okay, moving on. China lands probe on far side of the moon. We know that because of its because moon is tidally locked with the earth. That is, its speed of rotation and speed of revolution is the same. Therefore, the back side of the moon, we cannot see it. Therefore, it is called dark side. Previously, no spacecraft has ever landed on this side. However, photos were taken, but they did not land. Chang'e 4 is the first probe to land on the dark side of the moon. The objective of Chang'e 4 is to take astronomical observation, survey moon's terrain, landform and mineral makeup, and measure neutron radiation and neutral atoms, okay, to study the environment on the far side. This is the objective of Chang'e 4 lunar probe launched by China. China National Space Administration. Moving on. Mahindra Finance has raised ₹3,500 crores via NCD. What is NCD is important for an exam purpose. NCD is known as non-convertible debentures. Let us first go into what is a debenture. Debenture is a debt paper. That is, whenever company wants to raise money, it needs money, it does not go to the banks. Okay, it directly issues a debt paper so that when any person, they can buy a debt paper. Okay, it says that after 1 year, you will get 10 to 11 or 9 or 8% or some percentage of return will be given. Okay, this is known as debenture. Okay, convertible debenture, since they can be, okay. Now, debentures are of two types. Firstly, convertible debenture and non-convertible debenture. Convertible debenture means that after 1 year or 2 years, if the company is not able to repay the money, okay, that will be converted into equity, or that person who holds the debt paper will become a shareholder. Non-convertible debenture means that the option of conversion into shares on maturity is not there. The company has to compulsorily return the money to the person who is holding the debt paper. Okay, the reason, this is highly risky, right? We cannot trust whether the company is going to repay the money or not. Therefore, because the risk is high, the interest is also high. So, okay, normally if you deposit in the bank, this much money will not come. But since, because the interest is high, many people go for this debenture instruments. Another important thing is there are two types of non-convertible debentures. They are secured non-convertible debentures and unsecured non-convertible debentures. A secured NCT means that if the company at any time fails to repay the money, its assets can be sold and the money will be returned to the holder. Unsecured means that if the company cannot pay, there is nothing the holder can do. Okay. Therefore, to protect against all this, every company that is going to issue the NCD, it has to get a rating, credit rating from the credit rating agencies, CRISIL, ICRA, CARE and Fitch Ratings. Only if the rating is very good, that is AAA or AA stable, only then that company can issue debt papers or NCD. Now, this is another interesting is that this is the primary market. That is, the debt paper is directly given to the person. Okay, this debt paper can also be sold on stock exchange. Okay, this is known as the secondary market. And the profit that a person makes on the secondary market is known as capital gains. Capital gains is taxed separately. Small term capital gain and long term capital gain. However, the person, that money that person gets on this primary market is shared according to the income tax. Okay, moving on. Cabinet approves the amendment to Constitution Scheduled Tribe Order Bill. Okay, this has revised that Scheduled Tribes of Arunachal Pradesh. Let us go through this. Firstly, the name Abhor is deleted in the list, as Abhor is same as Adi. Okay. Next, this tribe Thai Kamti is written instead of just Kamti, and Mishmi Kaman, Idu and Tarong. These three tribes are included in the list. Mishmi Kaman, Idu and Tarong. Okay, these are the three different subtypes in Mishmi tribe. Okay, they also included Monpa, Memba, Sartang and Sajolong. Okay, these four tribes are also included. And the word any Naga tribe is replaced by specific names. Nokte, Tangsa, Tutsa and Wancho. These are the Naga tribes who are staying in Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, this name is also replaced. Okay, this is for today. Thank you so much for viewing this video. If you like this, please like it, share with your friends and subscribe to the channel. Thank you. See you tomorrow.